why is this called a Go Festival?
Well, I think the name says what we had in our heart. We believe that God wants to raise up a new wave, if we can call that, a kind of voluntary army of soldiers, young people, 18 to 25-year-olds, who will go out and do great exploits for the Lord. We have close to 5,000 young people, with many more than we expected, and we're expecting thousands more for the weekend.
Great.
So we're really excited with the turnout that we've had for the Go Festival in Randers, Denmark.
Youth with a Mission feiret sitt 25-årsjubileum, ikke ved å se seg tilbake, men ved å inspirere ungdom til å formidle evangeliet på tradisjonelle og mindre tradisjonelle måter.
This has just been a challenging week to me of just encouragement and increasing vision.
I've learned a lot about God's will and being in God's will. What happiness you can find as you're in God's will, really.
I wanted to know more about Jesus. I wanted new start.
Bueno, buscaba alguna chispa que me hiciera sentirme más en mi relación con el Señor, ¿no?
Mina förväntningar det var att möta de som startade YWAM Mission.
Well, the thing that pleases me is these young people that have come here from many nations of the world, they're my friends, they're my co-workers. I'm just one of them, and they've come here from all over, and if there were only three, I wouldn't care, but I'm glad that there are thousands.
Well, that's great. Why is this called a Go Festival, Lauren?
Well, Jesus said to go into all the world and preach the gospel to every creature, and this festival becomes a global opportunity for young people that are coming here. They're coming to Randers to actually go into all the world. They're going to 100 cities of Europe on both sides of the Iron Curtain right from this conference, so that's why it's go.
Randers har vært et knutepunkt i Danmark i mange hundre år, og byen har bevart mye av sin gamle charme. Den av innbyggerne som nok best kjent, storken som bor midt i byen på taket av turistkontoret. Faktisk bor to av Danmarks 13 hekkende storkepar I sentrum av Randers. Byen har I alle år vært et handelssentrum, og kjøpmennene har mye som kan friste tilreisende. Idrettshallen var målet for den svært internasjonale forsamlingen som kom til Go-festivalen, med deltakere fra 35 land over hele verden. Et stort apparat var satt I gang for at deltakerne skulle få den informasjon de trengte for å få best mulig utbytte av konferansen. Møte med mennesker. Gjensyn med venner. Nye bekjentskaper. Det vil alltid være en viktig del av en konferanse som denne. Så mange mennesker som har én ting felles, nemlig at de ønsker å forkynne evangeliet om Jesus Kristus. Gjennom en lang rekke seminarer holdt forskjellige steder rundt I byen, og hovedtalen holdt I Randershallen, møtte deltakerne utfordrende forkynnelse om evangelisering.
That's not the way you handle these problems. So we made him an usher to take the offerings.
are not celebrating Youth with a Mission.
Vi feirer ikke ungdom med oppgave.
We're celebrating God's faithfulness.
Vi feirer Guds trofasthed.
To Youth with a Mission these past 25 years.
Ungdom med oppgave I disse siste 25 år.
What has been the highlight of the conference for you?
Die Predigt von Joy Dawson.
When Joy Dawson spoke on God, that really inspired me a lot.
He's God.
Han er Gud.
God.
Gud.
Almighty God.
Den allmægtige Gud.
I'm going to give you my rave right now.
Nu jeg
går
give jer min praleliste.
He's supreme in his authority.
Han er den allerstørste I autoritet.
He's dazzling in his beauty.
Han er fantastisk I sin skønhed.
He's flawless in his character.
Han er fejlfri I sin karakter.
He's ingenious in his creativity.
Han er opfindsom I sin kreativitet.
He's timeless in his existence.
Og han er tidløs I sin eksistens.
He's by far the most exciting person.
Og han er den absolut mest spændende person.
He's unswerving in his faithfulness.
Og han er usvigelig I sin trofasthed.
He's matchless in his grace.
Og han er uden lige I sin nåde.
This may be the first time God has ever been in alphabetical order, but he is
this
morning.
Og det kan godt ske, at det er første gang Gud er I alfabetisk orden, men det er han her til morgen.
I'm sure he'd be pleased about that.
Jeg er sikker på, at det er han glad over.
For me, Safi Zakaria.
Yes, Safi Zakaria.
Young people.
Unge mennesker.
There is nobody here who has the heart big enough for the cries of New York City.
Der ingen her som har et hjerte der stort nok for skriget fra New York.
There is only one heart that can accommodate the suffering of a whole world.
Der kun et hjerte som kan rumme hele verdens lidelse.
That is the heart of God.
Og det Guds hjerte.
But follow me now.
Følg nu med.
God takes some of that suffering.
Gud tager noget af denne lidelse.
Takes a portion of it.
En del af det.
Puts it into a funnel.
Og så sætter han det ind I en tunnel.
And some of those heartaches are going to empty out into your heart.
Og noget af det, der skal tømmes ud I dit hjerte.
You cannot carry the heartache of South Africa and Nepal and Greece all at the same time and retain your sanity.
Du kan ikke tage smerten fra Sydafrika, Nepal og Grækenland og så samtidig bevare din sunde sans.
But I'll tell you something.
Jeg vil sige dig noget.
God is going to take some of you this morning and narrow down South Africa in your life.
Gud vil tage nogle af jer, og så vil han indsnævre jeres det til jeres hjerter her I dag.
He's taken some of you where the heartbeat of Nepal is beginning to pound.
Og jeg vil have med tage nogle af jer, hvor hjerteslaget fra Nepal begyndt at slå.
And the situation in Greece is going to be the burden some of you will carry.
Situationen I Grækenland vil være byrden, som nogen af jer skal bære.
But it's good to know.
Men det godt at vide.
That there's a heart big enough for the suffering of the world.
At der et hjerte, der stort nok til hele verdens lidelse.
And that God can prepare yours and mine to carry a portion of that.
Og Gud kan bevare dit og mit til at bære en del af det.
Are you ready for it?
Du klar til det?
They lacked one dimension.
De manglede en dimension.
The future.
Fremtid.
Hope.
Håb.
Faith.
Tro,
security,
tryghed,
forgiveness,
tilgivelse,
life,
liv.
That is the issue today.
Det det drejer sig om I dag.
You know it.
Og du ved det.
Everyone who has been here more than one day knows it.
Enhver der har været her mere end en dag ved det.
Everyone who listens to my voice now knows it.
Hver som lytter til min stemme nu ved det.
We have life.
Vi har liv.
We have good news we sang tonight.
Vi har sunget her I aften, vi har gode nyheder.
Then go and give it.
Så gå der og giv det.
En konference med så internasjonal deltagelse krever avansert tolketjeneste for at alle skal få med seg det som blir sagt.
Tu vienes demasiado tarde para unirte. Puedes ir por ahí, en el stand de Nínive.
Pero la está aquí, por las geestelijke zegeningen van Jezus Christus.
Te remercions pour celui qui nous apportera ta parole aujourd'hui.
Während wir zusammen beten, geben wir dir Dank. In Jesu Namen. Amen.
De som behöver ha murar för översättning på staden ikväll
must go through gates 2 and 4 only.
Ni får bara gå genom grindarna 2 och 4.
Evangeliet blir också förkynt av musiker från hela världen. Både under møtene I hovedsalen og på egne konserter under konferansen.
Halleluja!
you're the captain of the mighty hosts of heaven, and I.
En av konsertene ble holdt på stadion I Randers, så enda fler kunne få del I den forkynnelsen som ble gitt.
Song is all about. I got peace, peace and a river, river. Jesus, you've seen me through. I'm depending on you. That's right. I'm depending on you. Yes,
yes, yes. Det ord, budskap, det personer, det ånd I det vi gjør som kristen. Gud har gitt musikken til oss mennesker, til oss alle sammen, og vi kan forvalte musikk på mange måter. Det ikke musikkformen eller fremtoningen det dreier seg om, men som sagt, det ånd som forskjellen.
Hvordan kan musikk bli brukt til å forkynne evangeliet?
Det avgjørende for meg det at man skal være mennesker I det man gjør. Man skal være hele personer som deler noe som ekte her innenfra. Hvis man ærlig, så tror jeg man kan bruke hvilket som helst musikkform. Det kan være planlagt, spontant. Det kan være god eller dårlig kvalitet. Så kan det ha en effekt. Som, altså en slags, man kan være en ambassadørtjeneste som kristen. Vi skal gå ut I samfunnet. Vi skal lage vår lille enklave. Og så håpe på at det skal kunne rope over den barrieren vi selv med til å bygge.
In present years, we've heard, Don, that many have leveled the charge that missionaries are actually just foisting cultural imperialism on many cultures throughout the world. Would you have any comment toward that?
The question assumes that if Christian missionaries do not go out with the Christian message, that the peoples of the world out there will be left as they are. That's a false assumption. Christianity is not the only ideology in the face of the earth that is influencing people. There are other ideologies such as humanism, communism, Islam, Hinduism. And if Christianity stays home, they won't. They'll go in and take advantage of the vacuum and impose themselves. So we Christians have to ask ourselves, are we going to become static while these other ideologies are aggressive? And the answer is that we cannot afford to. If we do not go out to win other people to Jesus Christ, they will come to us to win us to whatever it is they represent.
Now, this is the amazing thing. When I look at those young people, and I'm going to tell them that to their face, you know the answer to their problem. Every man, every woman, every boy, every girl in Nineveh is lost. Every person in the world without Christ is lost. And I have the answer. What a tremendous obligation I am under to proclaim the message that Jesus Christ saves because God loves them. He died on the cross. This is the message. It's so simple. If once we do it, we go and we get ready, then we'll see the same results that Jonah did, only I hope we be a little more willing and happy to see those results than Jonah was.
There was once a man called Jonah, and God said to Jonah, Jonah, go to Nineveh and tell the people to stop sinning.
Righto,
said Jonah, and off he went to Joppa. Became a sailor.
La 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 la.
But God saw Jonah and sent a great wind on the sea. And such a violent storm began that the ship threatened to break up.
Here, any more of this and we're breaking up.
Jonah quite liked whales and stayed there. For 3 days and 3 nights. While he was there, he prayed and said sorry to God.
Sorry, God.
Whale Jonah. Oh, stop blubbering, said God. And told the whale to spit Jonah out. Jonah landed on dry land. And God said to Jonah, now go to Nineveh.
Oh, all right,
said Jonah. And off he went to Nineveh.
For your wicked ways.
How long have we got?
40 days.
What must we do?
Repent, ye sinners.
Oh, all right then.
Men en konferanse som dette jo ikke bare møter og seminarer. Det også tid til avslappning, til å møte nye venner, og å gjøre det man selv har lyst til. Noen var kommet sammen med mange venner, mens andre var mer alene. Og noen bekjente fikk man underveis. Mange hender må hjelpe til for at en konferanse som dette skal kunne gjennomføres. Til matserveringen, administrasjon og vakthold trengtes det mange hundre medhjelpere.
Why have you come to the Go Festival?
To work as full-time staff member.
With what?
In personnel, staff housing.
What would you say has been the highlight of the Go Festival for you?
Being able to serve others.
Why is that a highlight?
Because being full-time staff, you know, being very much in the background, it's just been such a blessing to see how you can be blessed by serving others.
Fast jeder Redner verschiedene Punkte hat, die man abchecken kann, wo man sagen kann, wie steht es hier, wie steht es damit in meinem Leben. Und so, ich mag das gerade, weil ich Theologie studiere. Ich schätze, ich sehe das Konkrete und nicht das Abstrakte. Es ist sehr schön, auf eine Konferenz zu fahren, wo das Glaubensleben allgemein gestärkt wird.
To me personally, it was after Brother Andrew's service. I think God spoke to very critical points in my life. So after we finished the service, I sat by myself alone with God, and I think this made a big difference now for me.
I like something like this when all Christians come together and praise God and so.
Ich wollte Gemeinschaft mit anderen Christen haben und etwas mit Gott erleben.
Och speciellt då när man sjunger sådana här lovsånger och sånt. Tycker jag är så fint, va? Så att man blir alldeles, jag vet inte, man är nästan som man börjar gråta nästan ibland.
I've been to so many speakers, and one of them was on worship, and that to me was the highlight of just finding out how worship in itself can be evangelism, and how that is just so important. It's just broadening my view.
Oh,
parental being, dance and Christianity. They're opposing ideas.
I don't believe so. The Lord called me into a dance ministry, and I began to look at the scripture to see if there was scriptural basis for his calling, which of course there had to be if it was a real calling, and I discovered that Psalm 150 says, praise him with the timbrel and the harp, praise him with dance, let all things that have breath praise the Lord. And I've found over the 10 years that I've been ministering in this way that there are many others who have a similar calling, and it's a valid way to worship the Lord and also to edify the body of Christ. Mm.
Worship, you mentioned just now. What part do you find in worship and dance playing in missions, world evangelization?
Well, of course, one of the things about dance is that it really does draw the eye of man. It draws attention tremendously. If you get a group of people out on the street preaching on one corner and doing a dance or a drama on the other corner, you're going to get the crowd at the group with the movement expression. There's something about the language of movement that grabs our heart.
Dance in evangelism?
Because God asked me to do, because he wanted to teach me that he can release any gift, what he give to people, and then it's so easy to communicate to people through dance. Because to me, I travel almost all over the world, and then we have so many different cultures and different languages. People don't understand, and I cannot learn all the language at once. But like all over the world, the people understand that movement.
There is one point that comes across all the times, and it's the joy that we have on our faces. And it's not, we always try to put on a smile for these people or for the places we go into, but because of the relationship we have with the Lord Jesus, there is joy in our heart that is expressed in our faces, and that's the first thing they notice. And they don't always understand the words, but it gives us a ground to start sharing with them about the real joy and the source of joy that is in our hearts.
Byen Randers fikk merke på flere måter at det var en misjonsfestival I byen. King's Kids Youth for the Missions barnearbeid, men mange har spurt seg om barn virkelig kan ha et modent forhold til Gud.
I've been very much convinced out of the Word of God and now in working with children that they really can know God. They really can join us as parents and adults in walking with God. So we feel that there has been enough fruit in the lives of young people and children from various cultures and backgrounds to encourage us that God is really wanting to involve the whole family in getting to know who He is and being a part of making known who He is.
Innbyggerne I Randers ble invitert til de to kveldsmøtene som ble holdt på stadion I byen. Mer enn 7000 mennesker kom for å høre evangelisten Louis Parlot, som av mange blir betegnet som Sør-Amerikas Billy Graham.
And we're going to ask all of you tonight.
Og vi vil gerne spørge jer alle her i aften.
To listen to a public invitation.
Og bede jer om at lytte godt efter denne offentlige indbydelse.
To make a public commitment.
For at gøre et offentligt standpunkt for Jesus.
A public decision, in a word.
En offentlig beslutning.
To publicly state.
Offentligt at slå fast.
I give my life to Christ.
Jeg giver mit liv til Kristus.
I love Jesus.
Jeg elsker Jesus.
I want to be holy.
Jeg ønsker at være hellig.
I want to live for God.
Jeg ønsker at leve for Gud.
The Lord's been speaking to you all week at this Congress.
Herren har talt til jer hele denne uge ved konferencen.
And now it's coming to a head.
Nu kommer det ligesom frem til et klimax.
And you say, yes, Lord Jesus.
Og du siger, ja, Herre Jesus.
I really want to settle this thing.
Jeg vil virkelig ønske, at dette bliver sat på plads i mit liv.
I want to be holy.
Jeg ønsker at være hellig.
I want to walk in the light.
Jeg ønsker at vandre i lyset.
Den sidste kvelden på konferencen talte Arthur Blessitt, predikanten som har gått verden rundt med et kors over skulderen.
Give me a J!
J!
No.
Nei.
That sounds like a bunch of downtown winos in Amsterdam.
Det lyder som nogle af dem der bor nede i midt i Amsterdam.
I mean, let them hear it all over Denmark.
Lad det høre hele vejen over Danmark.
Try it again now, come on.
Prøv igen nu.
Give me a J.
Hey. Jesus.
Who is Lord?
Jesus.
Who are you living for?
Jesus.
Who are you going to tell the world about?
Jesus.
And what are you going to do with Jesus?
Go.
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 Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Glory to God.
Your absolute commitment.
Du er absolut overgivet.
Will revolutionize the world.
Og det vil revolutionere verden.
There's enough in this building.
Der er nok i denne bygning.
Not only to turn Denmark upside down.
Ikke bare til at vende op og ned på Danmark.
But the world.
Men verden.
What are you going to do now afterwards the Go Festival?
I'm going to work in Nottingham for 2 weeks doing street evangelism, which I'm looking forward to.
Ein Einsatz hier in Randers in einer Gemeinde.
I'm planning to go to Holland. For outreach for 1 week.
Jeg skal på dramateam i Norge.
Mer enn 1500 av deltakerne ble med på evangelisering i europeiske storbyer etter festivalen. I Brussel i Belgia var mer enn 75 mennesker med på sommertjenesten. I 3 uker forkynte evangeliet gjennom musikk, drama og samtaler mann til mann på gaten. I Tyskland var 120 ungdommer med på en Jesusmarsj gjennom landet. Fra Frankfurt, gjennom en lang rekke mindre byer, og til Bonn hvor man hadde en større aksjon. De varme kildene kan være et symbol på hva vi ønsker skal skje på Island. Landet som for 1000 år siden demokratisk vedtok å være et kristent land. Men det trengs å fornyes innenifra.
Morgen etterpå. Hva?
Evangelisering kan også være svært behagelig når man kan kombinere det med sol, sommer og strandliv. Amsterdam på mange måter en idyllisk by, men samtidig det den by I Europa hvor ondskapen tydeligst ses. Mer enn 300 mennesker var med på å forkynne evangeliet I Amsterdam I sommer. Evangelisering og misjon dypest inne det å dele en personlig opplevelse, et hjerteforhold til Gud, med et annet menneske.
What have you done here in Europe?
Well, we've been on the streets worshiping God and sharing, you know, that Jesus is the Lord with the people of Belgium.
Do the people respond?
Yes, many of them do. They want to really hear. There's a lot of people that really need to know that there's somebody that cares about them. And they need to know what Jesus did.
Do they know much about Jesus from before?
A lot of people just know of him, but they don't know that they can have a personal relationship with Jesus.
And you can help them to have that.
Yes, that's what I'm here for.
Was macht sie eigentlich hier in Brüssel?
Ja, wir versuchen zu evangelisieren, das heißt, die gute Botschaft, dass Jesus Christus gestorben ist für die Menschen, für alle Menschen, den Menschen zu sagen.
Wie die Leute hören?
Teils, teils. Ich empfinde es so, dass manche gar nicht hören wollen, aber manche sehr offen sind und bereit sind, sich einzulassen auf ein längeres Gespräch auch. Und sogar manche bereit sind, wirklich ihr Leben Gott zu geben.
Gibt's es?
Ja, doch. Das ist die Erfahrung, die ich machen konnte. Und ich bin sehr froh darüber, das zu sehen.
God loves people. Jesus did not die for the cause of world evangelism, Perry. He died for people. And we must see people through God's eyes. That begins in prayer. I believe that if young people want to have a passion, a compassion for the lost, they need to be alone with God in prayer. As we spend time alone with God, He will put into our hearts the love that He has for people.
I want you to take the hands of one another, if you would. Take one another's hands and lift those hands unto the Lord, and let this be a declaration of a generation. A declaration of a generation that says, I'm abandoned unto you, O Lord, to finish the task. To see this world covered with the glory of God, even as the waters cover the sea. I'm a man.
Last week I had a mail from Asia.
Sidste uge fik jeg et brev fra Asien.
It was a page from, I guess it was a Youth for the Mission paper or so in Manila.
Jeg tror, det var fra et UMO-blad I Manila, en side derfra.
There was a quote on it by C.T. Studd, my favorite missionary.
Og der var et citat fra C.T. Studd, min favoritmissionær.
And this was the ad.
Og det var annoncen, der var der.
Do it.
Gør det.
I love it.
Og jeg elsker det.
The shortest message you could preach.
Det det korteste budskab du kan prædike.
Do it.
Gør det.
Will you?
Vil du?
Will you?
Vil du?